actress Morven Christie joins us now. Delighted to have you. Lovely to have you. We spoke to was Lee Ingleby on the programme last week. Yeah, we're talking about the A word as well. I mean, it's a programme that deals with such an important issue. I remember him talking about how much research he'd done into it as well. Was that something that was important to you too?
Yeah, I think when we did the first series, I started to kind of do research, and then I realised that I was kind of putting myself ahead of the character in terms of what I knew, because Alison just didn't have a clue. Mm. And that was where all her terror came from. So I kind of stopped. But then this year, she's really done her homework. So I really did my homework.
She really has, because you come back to the story sort of a couple of years later, don't you, when things have really changed and the little boy is at school.
Yes.
And obviously that brings its own difficulties, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, I think with autism disorder, things become clearer as kids get older, what difficulties they're going to have and what differences they have. And with Joe, his difference at school is starting to really show up and cause problems for him, but also cause problems for other kids. And I think the way that other families are handling it, or the way that the school is handling it, is maybe not ideal for Joe. So, yeah, it's about trying to find a path for him where he gets what he needs. So, yeah.
And I'm sure the way that the story is now following on, I would imagine that lots of people who have children who are on the spectrum somewhere really... the programme really resonates with them. Do you get quite a bit of feedback on that issue?
Yeah, we do. And we get it from both sides, actually. We get, you know, thank you, it's so good to actually see this. This was what my experience was. Mm. But we also get people saying, you know, it wasn't like this for us. It was completely different. Mm. We were really relieved when we found out, or, you know. And I think that's almost been one of the most challenging things about it, is that this is just the story of one family, and every child is different, whether they're on the autism spectrum or not. So, I think what's wonderful is that because this is telling a story about a family with autism, you start to realise that because that isn't a story that's been told, there are people just kind of crying out for it, I think. You know.
And it's not just the parents of people with children with autism, for example. It's kind of the impact that it has on other people, because there are lots of questions that people want to ask, and actually the programme in some way answers them.
Yeah, yeah. I think Joe has this thing with his headphones, right? He likes to wear these headphones.
He plays great music.
He has a 50-year-old man's taste in music, which is slightly odd, but we won't talk about that. Bowker. I have a friend whose little boy has autism, and he wears ear defenders or headphones quite often. Mm. And now people are much more... She just said people smile at us now.
Right.
And that's quite... I think that's incredibly profound. He's welcomed in a way that maybe he wasn't before. Yeah. So that's good.
We need to talk to you about the replacement as well, because...
We could hardly talk about it.
We were saying to you earlier, I used to watch it on an evening because I was obsessed. Louise would watch it the next day, so I wasn't allowed to talk to her about what was happening.
Ah, that's the worst.
But there are sometimes in television, isn't it, when everybody is talking about a programme. It must be lovely to be a part of that. And also, you have those televisual moments where people are actually sort of standing up and shouting at the telly because they were so involved. Like the falling down the stairs, you know, she didn't do it! It must be amazing to be so... obviously part of something which is such a huge conversation for people.
It was so strange because we had no idea that that's how it was going to... We had such a laugh making it. We had such a brilliant time, but I don't think we had any idea that it was going to be quite so massive and that it was going to be such a talking point. But, yeah, I mean, that's how we felt making it. It was like, I didn't push her!
Was it true that you and Vicky McClure were FaceTiming each other, talking about the reaction to people on social media to the programme?
Yeah, it was because it was mental. Neither of us had ever experienced it before. It was the scale of it was just like, it was madness.
So, is it going to come back, the replacement?
I mean, I just can't imagine what you would do with it. It was always intended to just be, you know.
You're such great characters, though. It was
absolutely... Oh, we had the best time.
Brilliant. I may have to go back and rewatch it, actually.
I mean, I loved it.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
And the A word returns. I'm sure lots of you are watching it on BBC One tonight at 9 p.m. Now,